Hi guys, welcome to my channel. This gist is actually about Joyce Blessing and her husband Dave Joy, who is a producer and all. I just saw on Zion Felix Instagram page that Joyce Blessing and her husband, their marriage is on the rocks and it's actually gotten to the point of divorce. So I watched a video of Zion Felix addressing the issue, and he called one guy. He said the guy is called Romeo, and the guy spoke about what is going on, and he actually said the man is accusing Joyce of infidelity, like she's having an affair outside her matrimonial home. And when she was confronted, she actually said she has already lost interest in the marriage and she doesn't even want the marriage again. So and as it stands now, Joyce Blessing's case, she and her husband, their case have been taken away from Joyce, and rather the man has taken the case to his sister's place or something. Zion is a blogger, okay, and he's a young guy. As much as he's doing his job, I really think issues concerning marriage is very sensitive, and Zion shouldn't have come out with it. Not at all. I didn't expect this from him. He should have contacted Joyce Blessing, contacted the husband, spoken to them, asked them, will you be okay if I bring it out to the public? If they disagree, don't bring it out. I don't like the fact that Zion brought the news out to the public in the first place, because it's a marriage issue. Marriage issues are very sensitive issues. So in fact, Zion, you didn't do well. You were rushing. Maybe you wanted to break the news, but seriously, you see, you are blogging, but certain things are sensitive. Don't touch them until you are given the permission to do so, so that you don't create enemies. Ghana is a dangerous country. Somebody can bring you down just for doing such a thing. So Zion, you're a young man coming up, you're making it by the grace of God, but please, certain issues, get permission from those the issues concern before you bring it out. So let's talk about the whole marriage thing, okay? We all don't know the truth. We all don't know the truth. It could be that Joyce Blessing's husband is actually finding a way to make the woman look evil, because most men do that. They will fabricate lies on the woman so that they can get out of the marriage. And it could also be that what the man is saying concerning Joyce is true, but we all don't know the truth. According to the guy who spoke to Zion, the guy said Joyce Blessing actually debunked the rumor. But when he got in touch with Joyce Blessing's husband, he actually said it's true. And he was the one who told the guy that Joyce is engaging in infidelity and all. I asked myself, why is the man so quick to bring out issues when Joyce doesn't want to talk about it? But then right now, there's division. They are not one. So everyone is looking for his or in her own interest. What I'll say is that we all don't know the truth, like I said. And it's just something that is brewing. So we should give them the chance to deal with their issues. Bloggers shouldn't want to go into it right now because they are all not in a good state. And the issue with Joyce Blessing's husband taking the case away, what I'll say is that Joyce Blessing should make sure she battles the man in court for custody of the kids. Court should determine. Because most Ghanaian men always think that when they part ways with their wives, they have the right to take the kids and go and give the kids to their sisters or their mothers to take care of the kids. But seriously, Joyce Blessing, you carried your kids for 9 months. I don't know, I think you have 3 kids and they are all boys, either 3 or 4. You carried them for 9 months. You've taken care of them. You've suffered to take care of them. Don't allow your husband do whatever he wants to do. You are alive. You are not dead. You can take care of your kids. So take him to court and battle him in court. That is my advice to him, to you. Don't allow the man to do whatever he wants, because nobody can take care of your kids like how you will, because you have gone through the 9 months and you know what you have been through. I actually, there was this story on Instagram and the lady was saying that her mother-in-law, whenever she gives birth, her husband actually takes the baby to the mother-in-law, that's the husband's mother, to take care of the kids. So the husband doesn't trust that the wife can take care of the kids enough. The husband rather trusts the mother to take care of the kids. And I commented and I was like, this is total crap. Crap to the highest level. If you want to make babies for your mother to take care of, go and sleep with your mother for your mother to take care of the babies. But don't have a baby with your wife and believe that it is your mother that can raise the baby well. Like, what kind of nonsense is that? No woman should sit down for a man to determine who should take care of their kids, because you also have a say. You carry the kids for 9 months, so don't shut up. If it takes battling this issue in court, do it as you are supposed to. Don't keep quiet. Joyce Blessing, you have all the money. You have all the money to battle this man in court. Do that. And don't allow him to take your kids to his sister or his mother to take care of them. Like, what the heck? Nobody can take care of your kids like how you will. Me, that's the part that got me angry. Like, what's wrong with the husband? If you don't trust your wife enough, why did you marry her? If you knew she had a bad character, why did you marry her? So my advice to Joyce Blessing, don't keep quiet. Battle the man in court. Make sure you get custody of your kids and take care of them and give them all the love they deserve. If the marriage is not going to work again, fair enough. So guys, I'll be giving you updates concerning this their marital issue, but I'm not so concerned now, because seriously, it's a sensitive thing, and I wish them all the best. Okay, marriage is something you just can't predict, because the devil hates marriage. Like, the devil hates marriage, and the devil will do anything to destroy marriages, and will work through human beings to bring every marriage down. So marriage is not something to joke with. Yo, I wish them the very best, and I hope they resolve their issue and come back together and pursue their calling in Christ Jesus. Thanks for listening. Subscribe for more.